It's at the end of a country lane, just a stone's throw from one of the remotest stretches of the East Coast. But today, a firm few will have heard of was the centre of attention and the focus for animal rights protesters. B&K Universal is a Home Office licensed facility which for the last 3 decades has been breeding animals for laboratory experiments. It says it wants to modernise the site, but its opponents claim it wants to become the biggest dog breeding compound in the country, breeding up to 2,500 beagles for lab tests. Its plans have already been turned down by East Riding Council. Today, a government inspector, who's considering an appeal by the company, faced an unlikely welcome party. 9 protesters in dog masks and boiler suits.
Well, this is the inspector, as we can see. He will make a judgment, and that judgment will then go to the Secretary of State for Communities and Local Governments, Eric Pickles. But it won't be based on the rights or wrongs of animal testing. It'll be based on planning law.
And when the councillors threw out the plans in the summer, they did so because they were worried about the traffic and the access. It's a view shared by a number of local residents.
There'll be 32-ton tipper wagons. Every time someone goes past my house in a wagon now, the house shakes. The roads are not really built for those kind of conditions.
But this scheme has attracted nationwide controversy because of the intense debate over animal testing.
We're going to stop this proposal going ahead. First of all, the UK has already made a pledge. The government has committed itself to stop the use of animals or reduce the use of animals in medical research. The EU directive is also demanding all member states to reduce the number of animals used in medical research.
In a statement, the company said the redevelopment and modernisation is in the best welfare interests of the animals it breeds, and it added that the investment would bring new employment opportunities to the region, as well as providing much needed work for local companies. Managers here say they can't put a figure on just how many dogs will be bred if they do win approval, because it depends on demand from animal testing labs. A final decision on their appeal is expected in the new year.